So one of the really exciting advances in biology over the past couple of decades is the completion of the human genome. The human genome has 3 billion letters, and we have mapped these different letters. The cost for sequencing DNA has dropped significantly, so now we can sequence the DNA of many, many individuals. By comparing the difference in their genomes, we have now identified differences in the DNA sequence that lead to different disease. My name is Feng Zhang. I'm a professor at MIT. So a tantalizing idea is, what if we can go into the human genome and fix those letters that cause disease? Things like sickle cell disease or blindness or other types of neurodegeneration. And gene editing is one of the approaches for doing this. It's using tools, molecular tools, to go into the DNA of cells and be able to make these changes to be able to restore health.
Now, CRISPR is something that I've heard a bunch. I think a lot of people maybe have heard about it.
Sure.
They say, how would you explain CRISPR? Mm.
In order to edit DNA in the cell, we need to have a way to find specific letters in the DNA. And CRISPR is one of these technologies that allow us to go into the DNA, search through the 3 billion letters, and find exactly where that mistake is. So CRISPR is like a search box. You give it a piece of RNA that is designed based on the DNA letters you're trying to find. When you put CRISPR into cells, this RNA will take the protein from CRISPR system to go to that specific spot. And once it recognizes it, then it can go and initiate the editing and repair.
And what's RNA?
So one of the basic ideas in biology is called the central dogma. And the central dogma says that information in cells is encoded in the form of DNA. And the DNA has to be converted into RNA, which is the messenger. And then that RNA is used to convert protein or to produce protein inside of cells. And so RNA has a way of matching DNA based on something called a Watson-Crick base pairing. So DNA has four letters, A, T, G, and C. And so A base pairs with T, they match, and then G and C match. RNA is A, U, G, and C. So the A in RNA will match with T in DNA, a U in RNA will match with A in DNA, and then G matches C, and the C matches with G. And so when it comes to designing CRISPR to be able to edit something in the DNA, what we can do is we can read out the DNA sequence, and then simply design an RNA that matches that DNA. So if DNA is A, 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 G, 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 you simply design RNA that is U, 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 C, 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 and then they will be able to match with each other. So this is the search string that you give to a CRISPR system. So CRISPR has a protein. You give it a piece of RNA search string. They will combine together, and they will search along the DNA inside the cell to see where it matches. Once it matches, then CRISPR will get activated. It will cleave the DNA and then stimulate repair in the DNA.
You mentioned genetic diseases. Mm-hmm. What, on a very broad level, are genetic diseases? Mm. And how might gene editing offer a potential pathway towards curing some of those?
Genetic diseases are those diseases that are caused by a very specific genetic mutation. So in the 3 billion letters of the human genome, sometimes there's a single letter that is different, and that can cause a very severe disease. For example, sickle cell disease or a lot of liver diseases and kidney diseases, they are caused by single mutations. These diseases are very, very severe, and they affect a small number of individuals, but they really can take a significant toll on those people's lives. In contrast, diseases like cancer or neurodegeneration or diabetes, they are more complicated. They are often the result of both the genetics as well as the lifestyle of the individual. It's that combination that increases the risk for people to develop those diseases. And so with genetic disease, because they're caused by a single genetic difference, it provides an opportunity to use gene editing to go and repair those mutations to then be able to treat the disease.
Mm-hmm. When you look down at the horizon of what is maybe possible with this technology, what are you most excited about?
The CRISPR technology provides a lot of possibilities for treating disease and also for understanding biology. I think one of the really exciting areas of development is that we now know almost 5,000 diseases that are caused by genetic mutations. And so CRISPR provides a way to be able to develop treatments for these genetic diseases. At the same time, for complicated diseases like diabetes or neurodegeneration, we don't know enough about how those diseases work or what are the underlying mechanism. CRISPR provides a way to be able to study these diseases so that we understand them more. By understanding the mechanism, then scientists and drug developers will be able to develop more medicine to be able to target the mechanism of those diseases.
Are there some other kind of like really prevalent diseases in our society that are also targets that people might see this technology as a hope?
Genetic diseases are diseases caused by single mutations. Sickle cell is one of them. Polycystic kidney diseases that affect quite a few people is another form. There are blindness that affect cells in our eye that senses light. And then there are also neurological diseases like Huntington's disease that are caused by single gene mutations. So there are a lot of them, almost 5,000. And CRISPR and gene editing provide some possibilities for being able to treat the disease by directly changing these mutations in the genome.